talking with Martin Horsey, one of the actors in the upcoming movie Centurion AD. So welcome, Martin. How are you?
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Good. Glad to have you here. So I'm wanting to know, first off, what role do you play as in this upcoming movie?
I play the role of Basil Mason.
Basil Mason, that's an interesting name.
Yes, it is.
Basil.
I think it was concocted purposely for me by the writer. I don't know whether to give me a bad time or to just make the character more, you know, more full.
Interesting.
Yes.
So Basil Mason, who is Basil Mason in this movie?
Basil is a multi-layered character. He's a minister, and he's an author. So he's got some independent wealth, obviously, because of, you know, what he does with his time chasing around Archer, which you probably know about already. But he's, when I say multi-layered, he's a minister, and he writes about Christianity, and he loves and promotes Christianity. But he's not a goody two-shoes. He's actually a chain-smoking minister. And he has a little bit of edge to him as well.
So. A little bit of... Now, that sounds like an interesting character. Chain-smoking minister who's an author.
Exactly.
So, how does it come together that you end up in this particular role as a chain-smoking author who's a minister in this movie?
Well, it's like a flashback to way back. And I think there's a scene in the movie which depicts this, that when I was a child, I had a father who was very sick. And... the main character, Archer, comes by and heals my father. And I was just a child, but I never forgot that. And as I grew up and grew older, it became more important to me to find out, you know, who this guy was and find out about it. Because obviously that's an intriguing thing.
Yeah, if he saves your father.
Yeah.
So in this movie, if this gentleman, Archer, heals your father, are you on a quest to find Archer then? Is that what you're
doing? That's basically it.
Okay.
I couldn't put any better than that. It's a quest. It is.
So does he take us through the adventure, if you can, without giving away too much detail, because we know moviegoers are going to be going soon. So can you kind of give us a little idea of what are some of the things Archer encounters as he's pursuing, your character pursues as he's pursuing Archer?
Well, it's one of the things that drew me to the movie in the first place was the premise. I hope I can give you a little bit without giving too much away.
Okay.
The fact that Archer is basically immortal. The centurion that pierced Christ at the cross, and the blood came upon him and made him immortal. And he's spent his life going through, basically, doing good, helping people, and also fighting the bad guys, fighting demons. So
sounds interesting.
That's what makes the movie work. I think is that it's entertaining because it's exciting. You know, it gets you going. There's some great action scenes, but it's also inspirational.
Well, good. So when you say it's exciting, you know, I'm sure moviegoers, will they be on the edge of their seat, kind of? Like, will there be some points where there's some cliffhangers?
Absolutely. I was on the edge. I was on the edge of my seat waiting to go on camera. So I'm in that scene. Oh.
You're funny. So not only entertaining. You try. So not only entertaining, like riveting on the edge of your seat, but inspirational. I think that's a great combination. You know, when you see so much of what we, you know, is projected on the big screens, it's not a reflection of that at times. Yeah. So this is kind of a shift from probably what some moviegoers are accustomed to.
Exactly. Yeah. In fact, the main character, Archer, is not the only really inspirational one. It's what's accomplished through the movie. Actually, the character with the biggest character arc is Kim, the woman that I team up with, because she starts off as an atheist, or maybe agnostic, but by the end of the movie, she's become a complete believer. So we sort of follow her transition throughout the movie, and it's great to watch with all the excitement happening in the meantime, demons showing up, and you know.
Now, do you have to encounter any demons yourself?
I do, but I'm sort of a chicken. I sort of hide behind the main character, Archer, when that happens. I don't do any fighting of demons.
You're not ready to take on the demons.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Not physically, anyway.
Not physically ready. Well, that is right there. I mean, that's not something probably moviegoers are used to, seeing demons and angels. You know, we get a lot of science fiction, but not a lot of demons and angels. Do you think the audience is ready for that?
Well, there's been some movies and, you know, some stuff. Product out there that's that, you know, that goes along those lines, but this sort of steers it back into the inspiration where it's promoting the Christianity. Yes, that's the good part about this. I mean, that's what makes it different.
Well, you know, I'm glad to see something like that on the big screen as a Christian myself. You know, it's great to see you know, faith-based movies coming out. You don't see many of them. Mm-hmm. Do you think moviegoers are ready for that? Are they just hungry? When was it going to come?
I just think once it's out there, you wait and see because of, the United States of America is not the East Coast and the West Coast. There's a country between. And we're a Christian country. It may be so politically incorrect to say so.
And you know what? You say politically incorrect, but I mean, our country is founded upon Christian principles.
Correct.
So I think something like this, to me, is only natural that we would be seeing that, but so much of what we see in Hollywood isn't that. So it kind of does, you know, make you wonder, how will moviegoers respond? What do you think?
I think they'll respond well to it. I really do. I think they'll come out, they'll tell their friends, and you'll see whole church groups come out and see this.
Do you think it'll be something kind of the big movement that we saw with The Passion? Do you think it'll have a similar sort of...
That would be lovely. I don't want to make predictions. I don't want to be sitting back here in 6 months saying, "Oh, sorry." I don't know, but I certainly hope so. You know, I worked with the director before, Brian, in a short, an award-winning short that he won called No Experience Needed, and so. You know, people say, "Well, how did you get into that? How did you audition and get in?" Well, I didn't really have to. I'm sort of like a friend.
That's good when you have the end.
Yeah.
Now you mentioned Brian, the director. Mm-hmm. What was it like working on set with him and just working through that whole entire process with Brian?
Oh well, let me see if I can say something about
him. Is there anything that you can kind of pull out of that file that's good?
You know, something actually. No, I'm just kidding. He's a real nice guy. Like I said, I've worked with him before, and he's not just somebody I've worked with, he's a friend. You know, we've collaborated before on other projects. So
I guess you were excited then to be a part of this.
Yeah, and one thing about Brian, he lets you know what he wants, and he lets you do it. And if you do get off course, he'll, you know, he's very kind when he brings you back on course.
I guess that's a good thing when you have a director who's kind and understands and kind of can give that direction to you as an actor that you need to make that role come alive.
Yeah, you know, it has to be fun. I mean, some of these scenes that we shot, we were up to like 2, 3, 3:30 in the morning shooting all these things. So the director had better be kind. And his wife made lovely cookies, so thank
you. Oh, I bet that helped too. Kept you coming back to the next day.
Yes. As I say with this one, since I worked with Brian before, he pretty much wrote this role with me in mind. You know, most of the roles I do anyway, I try and put a little bit of me in it. You know,
yeah.
I mean, Basil's a preacher, but he's also a cheeky little fellow.
He's a cheeky little So you brought your own personality
to
it, so that's good.
Yeah.
So I guess, was Basil at all like your character? I know you said like you. You said he's cheeky, but you brought your
little... He is and he isn't. You know, that's what's great about, a character and developing a character. But I always try to put as much of myself in it as possible if you could be more natural in the role.
Is it nice when you have a director? I know you mentioned Brian wrote this character with you in mind. Is it nice when you have a director who crafts a role for you?
Yeah, I think so. Because one of the things when he was doing so, he knows me pretty well. You know, we've known each other for a number of years, so... It wasn't a stretch for him to think about how can I write a role for Martin that he'll fit into nicely, you know.
So it was a natural role for you.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Well, I bet you're excited about this role.
I am.
Excited. So
yes.
I bet moviegoers are going to also be excited.
I hope so.
Well, good having you here. Thanks so much for joining us. We're excited to see this movie come out.
Come see the movie.
Yes, go see the movie. You heard it right here from one of the lead actors himself. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Alicia.
Bye now.
Bye.